Hello. Unless you've missed your boarding call, when you take the plane, you are seated in the company of other passengers. It's an opportunity to rest, to gaze dreamily at the sky, to enjoy your trip. Yet, have you never dreamt of traveling in the company of the pilots in that mysterious part of the plane called the cockpit? The cockpit is that area of the aircraft reserved for the pilot, the co-pilot, and occasionally the second officer. Affectionately called by many pilots the most beautiful office in the world, the cockpit is located at the tip of the fuselage and houses all the controls and instruments necessary for flying the plane. Its strategic position allows the pilots to have a clear, unobstructed view over the front of the aircraft. But access to the cockpit is limited and protected. As you can see, there are buttons everywhere. From floor to ceiling, and of course, each one has its importance. But what in fact are they used for? First thing to know, the layout of the cockpit controls is not left to chance. They are positioned according to their frequency of use and located in four well-defined zones. Above the pilot's heads is a panel of switches that allow them to control the aircraft's various systems, such as the exterior and flight deck lighting, the air conditioning, the pressurization of the cabin, or even the de-icing system. A long, narrow panel located beneath the windscreen houses the controls for the famous autopilot. The pilots define the speed at which the plane should fly, its heading, or the direction in which it flies, and its altitude. Once activated, the autopilot will guide the plane according to its predefined flight plan and flight parameters. Just in front of the pilots is a large panel comprising various screens called the dashboard. These screens enable the pilots to visualize and control the position of the aircraft in the sky, its speed, its altitude, its inclination. Yet they also enable monitoring of certain technical data such as the engine parameters. Lastly, the pilots share a fourth zone, this central console you see here, called the pedestal. Here, several onboard computers allow the pilots to program the flight prior to takeoff. Having entered various data, such as the aircraft payload, the quantity of fuel, and the weather along the way, the computer will carry out calculations so as to optimize the flight and to make the pilot's job a lot easier. The pedestal is also home to the controls for the starting and shutting down of the engines, the flap controls, the radio control units, and the weather radar. But also, and above all, the famous thrust levers. Along with a button that activates the thrust reversers, each engine has its designated lever that enables the pilot to increase or reduce its power according to need. In other words, to manage the speed of the aircraft. The pilots also have other flight controls, each on their respective sides. A broomstick, or a joystick according to the aircraft model, so they can incline the plane nose up or nose down, or bank it to the left or right. And also rudder pedals, allowing them to coordinate turns and thus maintain flight symmetry. So as to ensure perfect seating comfort and ergonomics, the pilot seats are fully adapted to each type of aircraft. From their design to the materials used to manufacture their structure, every last detail is taken into consideration to allow optimal integration of the flight control systems. But did you know that the cockpit also has two trapdoors, each of specific importance? The first enables the pilots to extricate themselves from the plane in case a normal exit proves impossible. The second trapdoor, usually located behind the pilot's seat, allows access beneath the floor of the cockpit to what is called the Avionics Bay. The Avionics Bay is a bit like taking the lid off your computer. Here, banks of equipment, some of which is designed by Safran, are installed side by side to carry out tasks and calculations, and to relay the data dialed in by the pilots in the cockpit. Essentially, this is the aircraft's electrical, electronic, and IT nerve center. And it is here, too, that the data recorded by the black box, located in the tail of the plane, is generated. So, as you can see, the cockpit is a complex space requiring great know-how on the part of the pilots. Hence, trainee pilots must undergo a long and arduous training process, as well as being in excellent physical and mental health, so that you can relax and contemplate the skies, or even nod off in your seat. There, now you know everything, or nearly everything, but before we sign off, know that digitalization is making the cockpit more ergonomic and intuitive. Soon, it may indeed feature a voice assistant.
Hello, Mr. McAndrew. Delighted to see you again.
To accompany the pilot throughout the flight. All tight, Captain. Let's rock and roll.